everyone, welcome to programmingandpython.com. I'm back with another video. Here in this video I'm going to tell you how to print the pattern of letter K. In the previous videos I told you how to print the patterns up to letter J. Here it's time for letter K. I will also link all the previous videos playlist in the description and also in the I button somewhere in the right corner of this video. So make sure to click that I button for all the previous pattern videos. So now let's get started with pattern of letter K. So this is the pattern I'm going to print. So now let's see how we can print this pattern. Let's assume the size as suppose 7 or something like that. We can later change the letter when I go into my PyCharm IDE while I code the program. I'll take this number from the user for now for this explanation. I'm taking this number statically as 7. So as usual, there are two loops, one for row looping and one for column loopings. These are called rows and these are called columns. So write two loops for R means range, for R means row. In range, yes. For C means columns. In range, yes. So I've written two for loops, one for row looping and one for column looping. So here I need to print conditions where I need to print stars and where I need to print spaces. So one condition would be this one. This is considered as one condition, but that is first column. And this complete thing I'll just mark them. So this would be one condition, and printing this would be another condition, and printing these would be another condition. So there are three conditions. So I'll print. So there are three conditions to print these three flows. These three flows. So now first this first column. That is if, that means if C equal to 0, that is first column, we'll print this stars. Or I'll write condition for printing these three. So for that condition will be row equal to, I need to start like this is 7. I need to start here. I started from 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It started at the 5. So what I'll take is, I'll just third. I think this is third, not even half. This is third. So what I'll do is, I'll do 7 by 3 dot x. That approximately gives to 2 and plus 1. Plus I'll do the plus column. Like if this column equal to 1, plus column. So first time it will print here, 2 plus 1 is 3, again it will go to 3, again it will go to 4. Column plus, I mean if that is 0, it will be 0, if that is 1, if that will be 1, column plus, and this should be S by 3. I am taking 3 times of it, so that it will start from here, and in the next iteration it will go here, and the next iteration it will go here. This S by 3, C plus S by 3 is for rows, that means this one, I actually am starting from this row. For that, this condition is here to start from this row. After basically what I will do is, I will just print stars at the end. At this end, I will start decrementing this and come here. And again, from here to I need to start. So before that, I am adding condition for this. That's why we are calculating this path, these conditions to get this path. So this is the condition R equal to C plus S by 3, and also column should not be equal to 0. That also you can write, and column should not be equal to 0, or you can write column greater than 0. So this is the condition. I have printed this for the first row, and this is condition for printing these three stars. So here in these two conditions I'll print stars. And I'll empty. If you follow all the previous programs, you will understand why I have given n as empty. By default, n takes slash n, that means new line. So it will print the star and it will go to the next line. But we don't want that. It should print the stars and continue looping and then print again. So that's why I am keeping it n as space. So I have written two conditions. This condition and this conditions are done. So I'll write condition for this now. So I'll write else if. That is, else if is called ELIF in Python. So in ELIF, what I'll do is, I'll just take some variables. I'll just take some variables like I and J. I would be 0 and j would be this s pi by 2 half. So what I need to do is I need to get the last position and then print from there. I'm also not printing from the last. You can see this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is also symbol. Not exactly printing from the last. It's not actually square. You can see here there are 7. I will write the numberings also. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see there are 6 here and there are 4 here. It's not a perfect 6 by 6 square. So what I'll do is I'll start from s pi by 2. That means it will approximately equal to 3 here. In this case, rho equal to 1. I mean, rho equal to 0. That means I have taken I as 0. That means from first row and column equal to j. That means it will take from the fourth. From here it will start. And again in the next iteration it will come here. That means the row will be incremented and column will be decremented. So what I'll do is in here in this elif, I'll just print stars. And as I said, this should come here. That means column should be decremented and row should be incremented. So for row, I'll write I equal to I plus 1. And for column, that means j equal to j minus 1. So in this way, if I write this row will be incremented and column will be decremented. So here in this case, I will print star. So it will print one star, come to the next line, print another star, come to the next line, print another star. So up to c greater than 0. If it comes here, c will be 0 and it will stop there. So those are the conditions for printing stars. And now finally, I need to print a space. So in if and else, I'll just print. I'll just print space. So all these spaces will be filled in all other conditions. So after first for loop, I need to print an empty print. Because after printing this whole line, it should go to the next line. So that's the reason I have printed empty print there. So that's the basic thing here. There are three conditions. One is for first column. Second one is for printing these three stars. And another condition is for printing these stars, these slanting shape. So for first column, I will write c equal to 0. That will be fine. And for printing these three stars, I will make conditions like I will take the size and I will divide it by 3 times and then add it to the column, so it will come around this value and then I will be incrementing that, so it will be incrementing. And here for this, I will take some parameters like I will be 0 and j will be this half of this or thrice of it, j s pi by 2 s pi by 3, and will start from there and will come down. So that's why I decrement a column and increment I so that it will print these stars. So next condition is I'll print spaces. So that's how we can print this pattern letter K. Hope you understood. Now I'll go into my PyCharm IDE, code this same program, execute and see the output. So here I'm in my PyCharm IDE. Here I'm going to write the pattern letter K as I just discussed in the whiteboard. So as usual, I'll take the input from the user. I'll take the size from the user. Size equal to input, and I will cast this to integer. And also I'll check for the size. If the size is less than 8, I'll tell them to enter a size minimum of 8. I'll just prompt the user. Else I'll be printing the pattern. And I'll take this size as the parameter for that, because we need to know what is the size of the pattern. So after this, I'll create a function here. And I'll take n as the parameter, then is a thing which you passed here as size. So here, as usual, we'll have two loops for row in range of n. This is for row looping, and for column in range, and this is for column looping. So we got two rows, we got two loops, one for row looping and then for column looping. And next, we need to print stars in the first column. This is the first column. For that, I write a condition if that is column equal to zero. We will print a stars in this condition. This is one condition, and as I explained, there are three conditions. This column is one condition. This printing this is one condition, and printing this is another condition. So first I write condition for columns and this last three elements. For that there is a condition called or. I'll just need to group this into a single one. I'll just give a parenthesis or, and here the column equal to zero or row should be equal to column plus n by I'll do a third, that means it will helpful, I'll do a third of it. So this what says is the column, that is column will be zero plus column will be zero, that is zero plus n is suppose if I give n as 8 or 9 by 3, it will divide float divide by 3. So 9 divided by 3 gives 3, 3 plus this column is 0, so it will start from 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So it will start from 3 and printing from here, and the next iteration will print here, and in the next iteration it will print here. Similarly, that is the condition. And if row equal to column, and the column should not be equal to this, the column should not be equal to this first column, or you can also say column should be greater than 0. So this is the condition. So in this case, I'll print stars. And I'll go. And I'll go n as empty. In all those videos, I told you why I gave this n as empty. I also explained this in the whiteboard, because by default, print takes new line, that is slash n as an n. So you don't want that, so I give this n as empty. So this is one condition, and for printing this first and for printing these three stars, I mean top stars, I make condition. So the condition is it will print the from the last columns first row, and last before column second row, and last that means the column will be decrementing and row will be incrementing. So what I'll take is here I'll take two variables, I equal to initially that will be zero, and then I'll take another variable j that will be equal to n the size, half the size. So it will start from half the size. If the take size is 8, so it will start from 4. So that it needs to print 4 stars. So if I'll take the other condition like row should be I and column should be j. In this condition also, I'll print a star. And here I also need to increment I. I is 0 here, that means first row I need to increment I and decrement j, that will be a column will be decrementing. So I equal to I plus 1, j equal to j minus 1. So this is the condition for printing this star as well. And finally, I need to print else. For printing spaces, else I'll print space. I also need to give n here. So this is the program, and after all this and after this for loop, I have to give an empty print so that it would go to the next line. So this is the program, guys. Now let me run this and see. I give a size of 12. You can see this is the output. I give a size of 8. You can see this is the K we want. This is how we can print the pattern of letter K. Hope you like the video, guys. If you like it, please consider subscribing to my channel, programminginpython.com. Also share these videos with your friends who might feel these videos helpful. I will also post the GitHub link in the description, also the blog post in the description, and also some other useful links. So make sure you're also looking at the description of this video. I will be continuing this pattern series up to letter Z. So stay tuned for all those patterns. See you in the next video. Bye bye.